In Fatal Favor news.
Ooh.
Ay, Dios mío.
Submitted by Strawberry Milk.
Ooh, that shit is good.
A man accused of killing a 19-year-old claims she asked to be murdered.
Mm. Let's hear the details before I say something stupid.
I want to hear your stupid thoughts first.
I want to hear what you got to say first.
Yeah.
What if she wanted euthanasia?
That's what he's arguing.
Yeah, that's just repeating the topic, the title.
Okay, see? That's what I'm saying. That's what the fuck I was saying. Okay, you guys made me fucking do it.
I just saw this like thought connect slowly.
It missed a couple times. Yeah, it missed.
In slow motion.
There you go.
We're like the slow-mo guys with points.
Yeah.
You know, slowly come together.
According to the man that they're suspecting that killed her, he's saying that she put out a hit on herself on Craigslist. Oh. And so he responded to that Craigslist.
In the hit section.
No, in the women seeking men section.
Oh.
And he says that he responded to that post pretending to be a hitman, but then the cops are saying now that his make-believe profession became real because they did discover this woman's body. Her name was Natalie. And so they found her body in a wooded area. And so her boyfriend reported her missing, and he also reported his Glock missing.
Oh no.
And so...
That sounds shitty, by the way.
The boyfriend?
They're just saying that, like, hey, my girlfriend's missing and also my gun's missing.
Yeah.
Like, how do you pitch that to the cop on the phone, man? I'd be like,
oh. And I didn't do anything.
Yeah, I swear to God, it's not me, you know?
I don't know what happened.
So initially in the early investigation, cops were focused on a 42-year-old man that Natalie had claimed that he was stalking her for some time. And she posted on her Facebook 2 weeks before her death that there was this man stalking her and that he's sleeping behind her job, her workplace for weeks, and that she's been telling him that she doesn't want to see him anymore and that he would park his car in front of her house and all this stuff. But when police questioned the man after her death, they ruled him out as a suspect. So then that's when they went into her phone and then they found 111 messages with this suspect now. His name is Joseph. He's 22 years old.
That's not enough messages.
Yeah, right? The cop's like, my gut tells me this ain't the guy. Like, you know, like, what?
No, the 111 messages is Joseph.
Oh, the boyfriend.
The guy that's being accused of killing her now at this point.
Oh, the cat from Craigslist.
There's a 42-year-old that's a stalker that she's been kind of like, I don't know about this guy. They investigated. He's just a regular pervert, right? Now, she has a boyfriend. She has a boyfriend. But aside from that, there's the Craigslist killer that she's been communicating, which is Joseph, that's a 22-year-old. Bam, I heard all of that shit.
You heard all that, and you have EDM music playing in your head.
I got house music.
That's so interesting that she actually had a stalker. That's fascinating.
Why is that interesting?
No, it's just like, that would be like the obvious suspect. But even then, they just see him, hey man, I just been jacking off to her face from a distance. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, right, exactly.
That's not weird. Yeah.
He's like, I just talked to her so I can nut later.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, okay.
She's so popular.
I just breathe heavy through a phone. Come on, bro.
Yeah, so this is Natalie and Joseph.
The Craigslist guy?
Ooh, her hair is cool.
Wait, where's his neck?
He looks like a human potato.
He first told the cops that he met up with Natalie to talk about her ad, and supposedly he was saying that he was trying to convince her not to go through with it, and that he ended up dropping her off somewhere, and like, that was the end of it. So he doesn't know if she might have just done it herself. But according to the ballistics, they see that the bullet hit her head from behind at an angle, like it was coming down.
Oh,
execution style.
Yeah, and that Joseph claims that that's how Natalie wanted to like go out. But he claims he never pulled the trigger. So the cops later on told him that they found proof that his cell phone pinged towers near that wooded area where Natalie was found. Then that's when he changed his story, saying, oh, well, you know, this is the way she wanted to go.
So he admitted to killing it, but is only saying that that's what she wanted.
Pretty much. And then now the family, Natalie's family, like her sister, is saying, not only is he lying, but now he's making my sister look crazy. She did not want this for herself. Like, she...
Why did he kill her?
Where's the messages? Huh?
What did the messages say?
Right, yeah, where's the... Dude, if I was gonna do this, I'd be like, yo, sign this contract, okay? Or some shit.
Yeah.
Like,
I'm not sure what the messages are.
It sounds shady to me.
Well, is there a real actual Craigslist ad?
That's a good question. Well, the cops here are saying that there were 111 messages between them, but there isn't any mention of a...
But they're just all... You know, how Craigslist works when you respond to an ad, like you'll have like that ghost Craigslist email ad that you respond back and forth to. So there should be a list of emails.
You know what I'm really disappointed about is the stalker didn't do their job. if the stalker was around.
Yeah, he could have reported.
Like, what the fuck?
Well, she told him to buzz off.
Well, stalkers don't usually buzz off after you tell them that.
That's true.
So maybe it was his day off.
So it's technically the girl's fault for getting rid of her own security guard? Because I would much rather have a person in the bushes with binoculars, right? And then that usually scares off someone else if you have someone in the bushes. But now that guy's gone.
Do you think the stalker was at home and his mom's like, what are you doing? Aren't you supposed to be stalking Natalie right now? Like, it's fucking 10 o'clock. And he's like, no, it's Sunday, so.
I mean, he was dedicated. He was sleeping behind her workplace.
Yeah,
that is. Dude, that fucking police call would have been really weird, though. He goes, hey, I know this sounds weird, but I currently masturbate to this woman that I see through a window every day, and there's a weird guy next to her.
Right.
And there's this weird guy right now that's about to kill her.
There's a fucking
weird
guy. This might sound really weird, but don't focus on that. There's a really weird guy inside. Yeah.
Weird. Got an almond neck.
Yeah, there's something wrong about him. I don't know.
Yeah, it's like fucking.
It looks like he swallowed like an Encyclopedia Britannica and just left it there.
You know? Shit.
We can make fun of him because he's a killer, okay?
Because he's a bad guy.
So is he in jail right now?
Yep, he's in jail right now.
So he's got to go to trial, huh?
He looks like he's going to get.
He's being held on murder charges without
bail. So the boyfriend is sad. The stalker is sad. Both of them, they just, you know. What's going on with them? Are this just sad times?
They don't really go.
Is everyone sad or are there some happy people?
Super sad.
There's some happy.
Couple happy people sprinkled in?
I don't think there's
in?
Anyone that's happy in this story.
Fuck. Yeah. So the boyfriend's completely ruled out. I wouldn't know that.
According to what they're reporting, yeah.
What's his alibi?
I think it might be a triangular thing. The boyfriend really wanted it done, and then like he got this other guy to kind of like get her. Like, what if he was like the crying, the guy to cry shoulder on, you know, the beta guy, the, what do you call those, friend zones?
Mm-hmm.
So he came and friend zoned her, and then like the boyfriend got in an argument, and so friend zone came pick her up and take her away, and then stalker was just basically scoping out everything. It's triangular.
I don't trust nobody. You know, like Craigslist type of shit though, you know, because even yesterday Mariel went to go buy some snow boots off of OfferUp, and I was like,
some snow boots?
Yeah, because she's going to go fucking.
I would have bought snow boots. It probably stinks.
Weekend.
Oh, okay.
Hmm?
Like, say, so it was selling some brand new shit.
You're
either
not
way,
going with her? Or going
absolutely not. And so.
Well, yeah, let's talk about that.
We'll talk about that.
You don't snowboard?
No, I don't snowboard.
All Korean snowboard.
You don't vacation? Just say, like, we're.
I just don't like enjoying myself.
Yeah, it seems like Muriel goes to a lot of places without you.
Yeah. So what happens is, like, if she does something very active.
He's trying to change the subject. God, can you.
I know, but I'm trying to get right back on track.
She does something very active that I don't like, and we've also agreed that you don't have to invite me.
I see.
Yeah, so what happens is she goes, well, I'm a bike for 40 miles. I'm like, great. Well, when you're done, let's have dinner.
I see. So, right, so you've done this a couple times, and when you went with her, it was miserable.
Yeah, because I'm going to ruin the moment. You know, I mean, I told her, like, I don't want to go to something and make it unenjoyable for you. So, vice versa, too. Like, she thinks about that for me, too. So, it's like, hey, I'm going to go watch this film where somebody gets murdered. She goes, well, you enjoy that. Let's have dinner after.
Gotcha.
Because I showed her a film in Hawaii called I Saw the Devil.
Yeah.
And then she.
Very enjoyable, so by the way.
And she cried, and then she almost broke up with me. So.
Damn. Yeah.
Because you showed her the movie?
She was miserable. She's like a very Disney, like, she loves Disney. She's very sensitive.
And you know what sucked, too? Because that film. Because so, in the beginning of the film, essentially, there's a serial killer, right? And so he rapes and murders women. And that fucked her up. And I was like, but you have to watch the whole film because she gets avenged.
Ah, that's cool.
You know, then you'll feel good.
That's the wrap up.
Yeah, see?
She never got to the end of the movie?
No, she cried and then she yelled at me. So it's all good.
Great. You guys have a really healthy relationship and it's always a pleasure to check in.
We've learned what we like and dislike. You know what I mean? So it's like, okay, if you don't, I don't want to ruin your fun, so I'm gonna just stay away from that.
So anyway, back to your story.
Yeah, either way, she went to go get something offer up, and I just don't really trust people like that, so I asked one of her friends to go with her.
Instead of you!
Because he was in the area. That's what it was.
That's hilarious. I thought you were going to say some heroic shit, like, so I got my ninja stars, fucking put it in my fucking jacket.
Oh, absolutely not.
No.
Because she was.
It's like Mariel's car broke down, like downtown. So I called one of her friends because he's good at tires. I don't do tires. Like, it makes me miserable. I just ruin the experience for her.
I don't understand what the problem is. So, yes. So I asked one of her friends and he said yes. He went to go help her out.
What are you good for then?
Oh, because they're already having dinner.
Wow. It's better and better, man. The hits keep coming. So she was having dinner with her guy friend, just normal, regular Monday night.
Yeah.
And David was just chilling at home, I assume staring at nothing, going like this.
No.
Enjoying himself.
I was on the phone with her and I was like, hey, Can you go with her? Just in case something happens. And he was cool with it.
And he's like, oh, hey, I'm already with her, man. We're having dinner, so.
No. It was a friend from New York that was visiting, and they were gonna have dinner. And afterwards, she was gonna go get the offer up. So I was like, well, don't go by yourself. Go ask the dude to go with you.
Well, at least you cleared it up.